Hello friends, welcome back, hearty welcome to you. As part of applications of integration, areas of the region bounded between curves, let's have a look at this example. We have been given y equals to 1 plus absolute value of x plus 1, x equals to minus 2, x equals to 3 and y equals to 0. We have to find out the area of the region bounded by the following curves. Now, x equals to minus 2, we know it's a vertical line parallel to y axis, x equals to 3 also, and y equal to 0 is x axis. Now, what about y equals to 1 plus absolute value of x plus 1? Now, how to know actually how the graph or how the rough sketch of this particular line will be. So to know that, what we will do, we'll try to find out what actually is y equals to 1 plus absolute value of x plus 1. So y equals to 1 plus absolute value of x plus 1 will be two straight lines, one for x plus 1 less than or equal to 0, or another one will be x plus 1 greater than 0. When x plus 1 less than or equals to 0, we know that y will be equals to 1. X plus 1 will be then at that time minus of x plus 1. So it will be 1 minus x minus 1, that's equals to minus x. Y equals to minus x. So what is the basis for this? We know that x plus 1 is equals to x plus 1 if x plus 1 is greater than 0, or minus of x plus 1 when x plus 1 is less than 0. So that's the idea based on which we are able to get this point. So when x plus 1 is greater than 0, y will be y equals to 1 plus x plus 1. That's equals to x plus 2. So we have two straight lines now. One is y equals to minus x, another is y equals to x plus 2. Now let's understand how the rough sketch will be. When we draw the rough sketch, we see that y equals to minus x, y equals to x plus 2. Both of them coincide at minus 1 comma 1. So we have to find out this area enclosed between x equals to minus 2, x equals to 3 and y equals to 0. So we are interested in this whole area. Now we'll try to divide this into two equal parts. For that, what we will do? Just make a vertical line here. Then we'll divide this into two equal parts. One part we will find out by using vertical strip like this. Another part also we'll find out by using vertical strip. Now, so this area is A1, this area is A2. So we have to find out A1 plus A2. Let's write down how the area will be. Area equals to A2B y dx. Can I say area enclosed is equals to, x values are changing from first minus 2 to minus 1, y is minus x dx plus afterwards. So this area is covered now, minus 2 to minus 1, y coordinate is given by minus x dx, this is covered. So then we have to go to this area. This is x equals to minus 1 to x equals to 3, and the vertical strip height is given by y is x plus 2 and here y is 0. So x plus 2 minus 0 is x plus 2. So can I go ahead and write down minus 2 to minus 1, minus 1 to 3, x plus 2 dx. Now this, if you are able to do and add them up by integrating, we will be getting our area. So let's do that. In the next step, I'll write down minus of x integration is x square by 2 and for that I have to put the boundaries minus 1 minus 2, then plus x by 2, integration will be x square by 2 plus 2x, and for that we have to put 3 and minus 1. Now let's take the first one. I will have minus of x square by 2, x is minus 1, that is 1 by 2, minus of minus 2 whole square by 2, that is 2 square by 2, that is 4 by 2, plus when we do 3, we have 3 square by 2, that is 9 by 2, plus 2 into 3, that is 6, minus of 1 square, minus 1 whole square by 2, that is minus 1 by 2. Afterwards, 2 into minus 1 is minus 2, minus of minus 2, we will have plus 2. Actually, you can do this with couple of more steps. I am just trying to close it fast. So we have 1 by 2 minus 4 by 2 is minus 3 by 2. Can I say 3 by 2 plus 3 square by 2 is 9 by 2 plus 6 minus 1 by 2 plus 2. Let's simplify this. We have 9 by 2 minus 1 by 2 is 8 by 2, 4. 4 plus 6 is 10. 10 plus 2 is 12. 12 plus 3 by 2 is 27 by 2. So the solution is 27 by 2 square units. Now you can do one thing. You can cross check the same thing by geometrically see whether we are getting the same area or not. Let's do that. Now let us verify this by using geometry, because we know this is a rectangle and we have two triangles. So if you are able to add all the areas, this is an easy figure, so we can easily find out area. Maybe sometimes it may not be feasible, may not be easy, but this time it's fine. So what is the rectangle area? Let's find out. Rectangle is starting from minus 2 to go to 3. That means its width is, length is 5, and let's say L into B, then B is nothing but 1. We know that because this height is 1, we know. So can I say that is 5 into 1? We'll write down that 5 into 1, taken care of rectangle. Then let's go to this triangle. What is the width of this triangle? Minus 2 to minus 1. That's nothing but 1 only. So can I say half into 1 into, what is this height? How to find out the height? We know this is 1 and y equals to minus x. That means x equals to minus 2. So y will be equals to 2 at this particular point. So this is height of 1. So can I say half into 1 into 1 plus, let's go to the other triangle. We have minus 1, 2, 3, that is 4, half into 4 into, and we know this is 1, and what is this y coordinate here? Y equals to x plus 2. 3 plus 2 is 5. So let me write down there. This is 5 and this is 1. So this height is 4 and minus 1, 2, 3 is also 4. So can I go ahead and write down half into 4 into 4? Now add them. 5 plus 1 by 2 plus 8, which is 13 plus 1 by 2, which is equals to 27 by 2 square units, what we got earlier. So when we have absolute or mod function, what we have to do first? First we have to understand how many lines we get, how the rough sketch of that looks like. Then we have to know our boundaries for x if you are taking vertical strip, or for y it is boundaries of how y will be changing. Then if it is vertical strip, integral a to b y dx, so y coordinate value I have to find out, and x where it is changing from boundaries, then we substitute, we can simplify and get this answer. So let's summarize that. We have been asked to find the area of region bounded by x equals to minus 2, x equals to 3, y equals to 0, and y equals to 1 plus absolute value mod of x plus 1. Y equals to 1 plus mod of x plus 1 is actually two lines meeting at minus 1 comma 1. One is y equals to minus x, another is y equals to x plus 2. Once we are able to do that, we have used vertical strips to find out the area of these two different parts, and we clubbed them together to get the area equals to 27 by 2 square units. So that's one interesting example I just thought of sharing with you. Thanks for your time and support. Bye for now. Keep smiling and sharing. Bye.